Here's the question, one first question. Are you saved? You know that you know that you know that you're on your way to heaven. There ain't a doubt in your mind. There, you ain't heard a sermon. The preacher ain't gave an illustration that even once gave you an inkling. I might be going to hell. If you've ever thought that, he's saved. Today is the second. If you're here tonight and you're saved, and you've never felt God move like you did the day that God saved you, or it's been a long time since you felt God like the moment He saved you, the problem. It's not the pulpit.
That's right.
The problem is not the church.
God.
The problem is you.
Yes, sir. Amen.
Behold, the Lord's hand is not shortened that it cannot save. Amen. Neither is ear heavy that it cannot hear. Amen. But your iniquities have separated between you and your God. In your sins, I've hid His face from you, that He will not hear. And I go a spell, and it hits me. I ain't felt it. I ain't heard it. It bothers me. I don't blame the Lord. I don't blame the church. I fall on my knees before God and talk to God and find out what is it in me. I'm allowed to creep in.
Yeah.
That would stop you.
Yeah.
Touch you.
Right.
Talk to you. Monday night before last, sitting in that drama down there. The drama was done. The preaching was done. All that was in the middle of the altar call. I heard him speak.
Is he ready?
I about come unglued.
Yeah.
Under that tent, but all I could do was sit there and cry. Because even the preacher could go through a dry spell. Even the preacher can let little sins in his life that he overlooks and pays no attention or just lets it lay there. But I'm glad when that little sin creeps in, there's a God above that says, hey, something ain't right.
Yes, amen. Yeah.
This is what the preacher does. Most of the time, I'll go ahead and get that thing right then. But sometimes, I don't pay no attention. And I go on about my way, and I sit and say, well, I don't know. I really don't think that's it. That's probably just a flesh. An hour turns into a day. A day turns into two. Two turns into a week. And all of a sudden, Miss Judy, I realize, you know what? I ain't heard nothing. It had to go all the way back to that moment where he spoke.
Yes.
And he said, you don't need this. Stop this. Don't. Whatever it is that he tells me. I don't need it. I didn't deal with it. I have to go back to that moment. But the moment I go back.
Yeah.
In the moment I steal one. In the moment I ask him, I'm sorry, forgive me, whatever it is, the language you want to use, but at the moment, and in this right here, and I turn back towards him, and I apologize and get that thing right, there ain't nothing like sweet communion. There ain't nothing like walking into the church house, walking under a tent, hearing somebody preach on hell, and be able to say, amen, hallelujah. There ain't nothing like walking into a church house under a tent, hear somebody preaching on heaven, and say, amen, hallelujah. Let them preach on whatever they want to preach on, but when you know things are right in here, and things are right up there, you can shout glory, hallelujah. you lay your head down your pillow at night, have that peace that passes all understanding. I'm talking about this time that you and I prepare for rain. Not just talking about revival. We're not having a series of services. We're not having a series of services. This ain't a have to. I need God to move like He's never moved before. I want God to speak like He's never spoke before. If there's something in there that needs to be out, I want God to expose it and get it out. I don't want to be the stumbling block. I don't want to be the hindrance. I want to watch more sinners walk the aisle. But I don't want to be the one that hinders the sinner from walking the aisle. But my question to you tonight is, how much of God do you want? Is it just a pacifier for your hard time? Is it just somebody to put you to sleep at night? Is it just somebody when life is falling apart? Or is He your best friend? Or is He, and that friend is getting closer than a brother? He's more than just a savior. He's my best friend. There ain't nobody like Jesus Christ. There's nobody that compares to Jesus Christ. There's no friendship, no relationship like that relationship with Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let's all stand tonight, everybody around the building. Let's prepare for rain. Y'all got my song here kicked up? Listen. Hands went up today in the sanctuary. Saints of God raised their hand and acknowledged, "Preacher, I know my life ain't where it needs to be at with the Lord." But I don't know, one or two that even made it to an altar. Think about it like this. You got lost loved ones. You got children. They're watching you. How you respond to God, you're teaching them how to respond to God. Don't you want to see God move in the hour which we're living right now? Search your heart tonight. I'm going to search mine again. I'm going to talk to God. You do what you need to do. But don't get upset when God don't move and do nothing in your hard life. But He's offering you now. He's told you, if you're thirsty, I'll pour it out. Didn't seek his face, or the book's a lie.
Yeah.
One or two things. But on that promise right there, he told me that if you'll come to me, and if you'll seek my face and you'll pray, and while you're praying, you'll be willing to turn from that wicked ways, forsake that sin, and walk with me, and fellowship with me, I'll forgive you. And you know what I'll do? I'll send healing to your land. You sit back and watch and see what God's going to do next week. I'm not looking for revival to show up. I believe revival's already showed up. I ain't waiting on Brother Trent to bring the right message. I'm just waiting on the service to start, amen. It's going to worship and praise him, God. Why? Because I believe that God has already started the healing process. I watched the work of some of y'all's lives under the tent. I watched our revival start the other week down there, and it's just creaking along. And you know what? Revival's like, it's like kudzu, amen. You know, then what starts growing, next thing you know, that stuff spreads everywhere. And next thing you know, there ain't no telling what God's going to do. But there's one thing I do. I wouldn't miss it for the world. I wouldn't miss it for the world. Amen. Amen. I'm done. 6:54. Amen. Remember tonight, some of y'all got the call out. If you are not getting the call out, you need to let Sister Nancy Harrison know. But Brother Dennis Yarborough had a stroke, and he was taken to CMC Pineville this morning. They transferred him to CMC Main Uptown. He is uptown right now. He is doing better than he was. Actually, Aunt Betty told me he was 100% better than what he was last night this morning. But they had a blood clot that was on his head and his brain. They gave him the shot. They're 90% sure that that shot will work and take care of the blood clot. Amen. Amen. And Miss Rachel told me you can still tell a little bit where you can tell he had a little bit of stroke. Hopefully that'll get better over time. The plan is they're going to do an MRI on tomorrow to find out, or sometime tonight tomorrow to find out what kind of damage, if there is any. Amen. We're going to pray that there ain't no damage. Amen. Yeah. And if everything shows up clear, hopefully he'll get to go home on Tuesday. Amen. Yeah. So you pray for Brother Dennis and keep him in your prayers. And give a call if you can. Make a visit if you can. We're going to go up there here in a little while when we get out of here and pay our visit. And so you just be praying for Brother Dennis. Brother Roger, you got that call. He should be getting home hopefully today. If not, the next day or two, he'll be home. And he's still got a long recovery to go. But keep praying for him. Brother Skeet had his surgery last week. He's on recruitment for, y'all know the word, from that. So keep praying for him also. Amen. Pray for Brother Benny back here. He had to leave today sick, but he's back tonight. Pray for him for that. But this is really what I want you to do besides pray for him. It's pray for yourself. I want you to get real selfish. I know it's contrary. I'm talking about both sides of my mouth. But hear me out. For the next 7 days, I want you to be selfish in the fact that I want you to get real concerned about your walk with the Lord. I want you to concentrate the next 7 days of getting all that you can get for you. Don't worry about me, okay? Don't worry about the wife. Don't worry about the husband. Don't worry about the church. You worry about you getting what God is going to dump on you.
Sir,
I promise you, if we all get concerned about ourselves and our fellowship and walk with Him, sit back and watch.
Yeah.
Sit back and watch. Amen. Remember sign-ups, seniors. Remember men, I need 2 liter drinks. Women, I need a dessert. Men in the church, next Sunday after church, we're going to set up feeding. What we're going to do, we're going to set up the fellowship hall, and I'm going to put some tables and chairs. It's supposed to be pretty weather, so I'm going to put some tables and chairs out here on the grass, right here for overflow, and we're just going to do it that way. We're not going to worry about putting the tent up, paying Metroburg County $150 to put the tent up, going through all that trouble, and tear it right back down, because we got to put it up in Antioch on Monday. But nevertheless, so I'll need some help. Next Sunday, after we get done eating, some of you men, if you'll help me just get the tables and chairs from outside, back into the garage, I'd appreciate that. Amen. Also, to make this announcement, it should be in the bulletin this month, the month of October. We ain't there yet. We'll be here next weekend. October the 15th. October the 15th. That should be Campfire Fellowship Saturday. Antioch does something that I call the pumpkin patch. A lot of y'all have been there. Is that what it's called? The pumpkin patch. All right. They have inflatables, games, food, and a bunch of pumpkins. Don't go to Walmart and buy your pumpkin. Don't go to whoever at Lowe's and buy your pumpkin. Go to Antioch, buy your pumpkin for the holidays, Halloween, Thanksgiving, whatever reason you're going to do with your pumpkin. Amen. Or make the preacher pumpkin pie. But on the 15th, they start about 12 o'clock on Saturday, and they go to about 6 o'clock. And they have singing groups, multiple singing groups on Saturdays. And on the 15th, Tyler McKinnon, they'll be down there singing, but I don't know what time or whatever. But what we're doing that Saturday is I'm inviting you to make plans and go. If you go at 12 and stay at 2, glory to God. If you go at 4 and stay at 6, if you go to 12 and stay at 6, I don't care. But I want you to go. And I want you to see that outreach. Number one, I want you to see the outreach that they're doing down there. Because we're sitting in a prime location. I had no idea about Brother Trent was sharing with me the other day. We're sitting in a prime location right out here. We can do a marvelous thing with a stupid-looking orange thing.
That's right.
Talk to them. But the 15th especially, we're going down there, okay? Go. But on top of that, I don't know what the dates are, but I know on Monday and Tuesdays, he's going to be having preaching under the tent. We're going to preach one Tuesday down. I don't know what it is. I'll let you know that. But he's going to have preaching under the tent Monday and Tuesdays. Saturdays is singing all day, and it'd be a good time of fellowship. You enjoy it. They got everything is free except the pumpkin and your food. They sell pumpkins and they sell food, hot dogs, corn dogs, and I don't know whatever else. But he did tell me about a 97-year-old lady that makes these fried apple pies. And he said they don't keep them too long. Amen. So I encourage you, mark your calendar, October the 15th. That's my anniversary, amen? We're going to celebrate our anniversary in the pumpkin patch. Amen? Amen. But mark your calendars for that. And Antioch is not hard to find. It's not hard to find at all.
In our house.
What highway is that? I don't even know how
to do it.
903. 903? 903. Highway 521. Hit the bypass right by Bojangles. Do the loop. Go down what? 903, that's the first. The second one? The second. Alright. Go down and hit 903. You can read them little signs on side. Take 903 and go down 903. The four lane's gonna turn to a two lane. When you hit the two lane, go about 5 or 6 miles, you're gonna come up, you'll see a big old, I think, a water tower out there. You see that water tower, the church is almost up under the water tower. Amen. Just be looking to your left. There's a great big old fine drink building. Sitting down side of the road, sitting on side of 903 now. Antioch Baptist Church, pull in there, and you'll find all the activities. Amen. And we'll have a good time. You know, anything else, Major? That's it, eh? Is that it?
Are you
going to
have breakfast Sunday morning?
Yes, we'll have breakfast. We'll have breakfast Sunday morning, and we're having dinner Wednesday night. Dinner here at the church is Wednesday night. We all have a dinner Wednesday night, 5:30, 6:30, and then we'll be fed up and ready to go to worship at 7 o'clock. Amen. Amen. Seniors, don't forget to sign up. If you have any want any detailed questions, ask Brother Jeff Pittman. He's the one heading up both of them activities for you. So if you want to know some details on it, you see him for that. Amen. Let's all stand, and we're going to be dismissed. Anyway, pray for Charlotte. Pray for the Scott family, pray for the men in blue, National Guard, pray for them mediocre politicians that we call up there, amen. You know you think the same thing, I just say what you think, amen, amen. But seriously, the Lord tells us to, sometimes I wonder why, but he tells us to. Pray for Charlotte for it. Pray for Charlotte for it. That's our city. I know 90% of our church, 95% of our church lives in the state of South Carolina. But our church, God put us in Charlotte, North Carolina. Amen. Father, we love you. God, we thank you, Lord, for a good day. God, I thank you, Lord, that we're ready for revival. God, I pray for the man of God. Lord, the church folks have done all they can do to get themselves right. They're going to do their dead level best, God, Lord, to seek you, Lord, and to stay close to you. They want you. Lord, I pray for that man of God. Lord, I know it was a last-minute thing. Lord, just got the call late last night, God. He had to preach twice today. God, I know he was busy running around today, God, doing his things, Lord. God, I know, I pray, God, Lord, that you fill him up. God, Lord, you let that man loose in this place, Lord, to preach to a dying man to a dying world. Would you give Brother Trent exactly what I need for us? God, would you give him exactly what it takes to charge me up, fire me up, keep me going? Feed me, Lord. From the preaching of the Word of God. Go with us to the next appointed time. In the name of Jesus I pray. Amen. Amen. Amen.
You're there.